Hey, what's going on? My name is Anthony Gray. Welcome to yet another episode of Grayscale. My last Facebook Live video, there was a question about trees. So what I'll do is I'll do a few different types of trees just in this one quick painting. All right. And what I'm going to start off with, I'm going to go right into it. And shampoo mix on my paper canvas here. This is 11 by 14 inch canvas here. Okay, canvas paper. Let me be specific about that. Canvas paper. All right. And what it does is it keeps the canvas paper wet, so the acrylic paint, I use heavy body acrylic paint. I'm going to take some water in my filbert brush. I'm going into the dioxazine for 1 second because I got to establish here for you what exactly I'm doing here. So the land mass is going to be like right around in there. Okay, that's where the faraway trees are going to go. We're going to have a birch tree hanging out around in this area here. Okay. And then I got the land cut off here. Comes down like that, and then it kind of, I'll have it bank right around in here somewhere, just like that. So here's the water. Okay, all right, so let's get to getting. We're gonna block in some color, and I can see right now I may need a little more yellow, so I'm gonna just get some more yellow, put it on my canvas, my little piece of canvas here, which is nothing but a coffee lid container. All right, let's block in some because we're gonna work from the, obviously from the back to the front. Okay, so with that said, let's work with a little bit of this. We'll work with the land mass right now. I'm gonna go into a little bit of green. I'm just blocking in, so I'm dragging my green out because I'm gonna put a hill in here. I'm just turning my brush around, getting some more of this green. I'm just using a 2-inch brush, and mainly this subject is really on trees. Okay, so I'm getting a little purple here, a little purple, a little of this cad red, purple, a little bit of cad red, a little green. I'm just getting some dark here. I'm using the fan brush to get to do it. That's the crimson, dioxazine purple, and some green. And we're gonna strengthen up this dark part all up in here. Up in here, get it pretty dark. This is for the base and the shadow of the tree line back there. That's what I'm doing right here. And matter of fact, I'm gonna bring some of that up in here. That's one way, the fan brush, you turn it sideways or whatnot and get your little dark shapes here and there. All right, I'm trying to, well, you know what? I'll use the 1-inch brush. The 1-inch brush will work perfectly fine. I need to put a little phthalo blue in this party because I need some deep darks, okay, to really set up against this background a little bit. So I'm gonna pop in real quickly some phthalo blue, and I'm gonna use a 1-inch brush that's kind of, I cut it. It's one of the cheap wood brushes, and I just took a pair of scissors, and I just cut, give it a nice little cut. I'm getting some green, getting some red, some the dark, alizarin crimson is what I'm trying to say. Now, this will bring a bluish green tint to some of those trees back there. All right, and I'm gonna go in various curious looking amounts in different directions, and I'll throw in some greenery in here. Like I said, these are like deciduous trees, okay, and nice light touch so you can have some interesting tops up there. And I'm not gonna, like I said, I'm not gonna get rid of all that brownish color. It's deeper down here toward the bottom, all established looking like bushes or whatnot. That should do it. Let's establish some bark in there. I'll just take it and give it a little slide, something like that. Okay, have some come a little taller if you want it, just like that. You can cut right into some of the sunlight there, have it go up there like that a little bit. And like that, bring some a little closer, a little taller, have some a little crooked like that. Okay, just vary them, add some interest to it. Some of them don't have to be that thick, some can be, you know, a little lean like that. Okay, and just put them in there. Okay, wiping off the paint, getting some more color, and I'll just brighten that up a little bit. Like I said, some can be lean, some don't even have to go all the way. Okay, just like that. Getting a little more of the purple, getting a little more of the yellow, mixing it in. And a slight touch of white, not much. It just grays it out. I'm in the habit of using the side camera, and I end up leaving my palette there on the table, and right now I don't need to do that. Okay, just getting off a little swipe of paint here, and I'm gonna go back up again so I can be seen a little bit like that. And I'll put in another nice size one right up around in here somewhere. Get a little more color. You guys don't see that. Just like that, and maybe pop a branch in there or so. And all you need really is a thin amount of color to do what I'm doing right now. I'll pop a branch in there. And some more little sticks and twigs up in there. Something like that. Okay. And that's basically it for that. Let's take I'm going to take my brush. I'm going to get back into a little bit of this deep color here. That bluish green, whatever. And we're going to establish, you know, maybe a couple of bushes in there, so they all don't appear to be directly in the front, not all of them. And just tapping in some color, bring it down a little bit, just like that. Okay, they don't all have to appear there. All right, okay, let's take a little bit of yellow, a little bit of white right in the corner of the brush here, slight touch of green. I'm going to get into the medium because I'm going to thin this paint out. A thin paint will stick to a thick paint. So I'm thinning the paint out with some medium. Okay. And then very lightly. Interesting shapes. Okay. Right from the bottom here, we'll establish just a few bushes here and there. Just popping a few. Some down there. Mainly where the sunlight is. You pop in some like that. And maybe a little bit hanging on the corner there. All right, I'm gonna get a little more white. Just a little bit more white. Mix into this light green. I'm gonna get some medium. I'll just dipping the least amount of hairs into the medium. And we're gonna establish for these deciduous trees a little bit of highlight on some. And you bring some down here like that. Okay, just a little. I'll turn it to the side, get some interesting shapes going here with some of these fellas. Especially down here by where the sunlight's peeking through. So we'll do a little bit of that, come down here, up near the top here. Especially near the not necessarily the canopy, but you know, the tops of the trees. You can round them off too, okay? And keep a dark spot in there. Just like that, cover up some of the wood over there. I'll strengthen some of these bushes here a little bit better. Just like that, I'll wipe that off. I don't need all of that. But something like that, all right. And believe me, you're catching pretty much all of it right there. So that's deciduous trees. Whatever type of brush you want to use for it, okay. And since we're here, I'll lower it a little bit, like so. Okay, now that I did that, now I'm going to take the fan brush and I'm going to give the land a little character too. All right, I guess I'll use a smaller fan brush, like this little guy right here. I'm going to dip a little bit of the fan brush into the medium, go into some of this light color. I'm going to give it a little more yellow for this light color. Pretty thin, okay. And you're only gonna use the top part of the fan brush anyway. And we're gonna go here by the tree line and we're gonna just tap in some. So you can tap in little textures, a little hill here, and goes down like that. Okay, just a little bit here and there. I'll keep one part dark and I'll put a hill here. Okay, and I have it come across like up front like that. And just tap some of that away. Smooth some of that out there. I'll smooth some of that out too. Rub it out a little bit. Just like that. Nothing really drastic. So let's pull back and you'll see what it looks like now. See that? So we got a little something happening over there. Okay. I'm just quickly rinsing off the brush. Let's go into some of this deep dark color here. I'll just use the fan brush for it. I'm gonna get a little bit of the red. A little bit of the blue. It makes a nice deep dark maroon. It's got some of the green in it, but that's okay. And right here down below, see this line right here? Let's establish. I'll just pull it across a little bit. Get some dark darkness here. Okay. Just here around the edge a little bit. All right. I can clean that up. I'm just happening to use what I got in my hand. I'll rub some of that in there, tighten up that look a little bit here, just like that. Take a thirsty brush and we'll clean some of that up there, just like that. All right, something like that. All right, nothing special. Just want to develop a nice edge there. All right, okay. So now we have these all set. Very simple to do, just layer them in there. You still got a little bit of the yellow back there. Okay, we'll play around with that a little bit later. Actually, we can play around with a little bit of that right now. Let's take some yellow. I'll pat some yellow out here. And a little touch of white. And what I'm gonna do is take most of this off the brush. So we'll go this way with it. Go right here. And very lightly, just drag it across. I'm taking off whatever paint that's on that. I'm gonna get some more white and some more yellow here. Cause the paint's still a little bit wet. And I'm gonna tell you again, I'm gonna drag it just like that. A lot of dark there. So I'm gonna have to use some titanium white for a second. There we go. Well, I'll just keep patting it because the paint's still wet. So I'll just put a little bit of that in there like that. I'll come back with the yellow. So let me just do it right now with the white. Make it a little whiter here. Have it come out. So the white's so thick. Okay, so I can kind of get away with doing what I'm doing here. Just like that. Just like so. Now I'm gonna go the other way. Just like that. Just have it peek through. Peek through here and there. And we'll have one coming off the, toward that way. Get a little wider. Just like that. Then I just get a little bit of yellow. And we're gonna coat that. A little bit of yellow on there like that. The white's already on there, so all I'm using is just the pure yellow. Just like that. The yellow's kind of on a thin side there. That's a little too thick right there, so we'll wear some of that away. We'll wear some of that away there. Okay. A little bit here, just like that. All it takes is a light swipe of some yellow, just like that. It lays right on top of that white and you're perfectly fine, just like so. So we got little bits of light going all over the place here, having a little fun with this, just like that. Okay, all right. If you can't tell, I'm listening to Nick Hackins, and I'm just fluffing up, brightening up the entrance, the light entrance there. I'm using a little white and yellow for that, and I'll just tap in some, a little bit of glow there, right in here, same thing. A little bit of shine in there. Just a little bit of shine going through. Circular motion, if you can do a little circular motion. Getting a little more titanium white, a little more yellow. I'm just tapping it right here, and then I can just kind of just little things like that. I can make that a little smoother. And I can brighten that up a little more. It needs to be a little brighter than that. I'll just tap lightly, just like that. Little shine going through a couple of these, just like that. Just like that, you don't need too much. Just don't overdo it. Just a little bit here and there. Little glow through, just like that. Just little bits of whatever. And there's gonna be trees and stuff in front of that, so don't worry about all that. That's just me playing around in the background back there. Okay, that's just me playing around. I'm gonna brighten this one up a little bit. Okay, all right, enough of that. I'm just messing around here. I'll get a little bit of yellow, and we'll tap in some bright where it may hit a little bit. Just a little bit of where some of that glow.
Put this brush back.
Let's continue on. We're gonna move to the lower land area here. Right up around, and let's do the one that's closest to us. We're gonna play with that right there. We'll establish a quick hill and whatnot. let's put some birch trees coming out of there. So let's pull back a bit. Okay, we'll raise the camera up. The birch trees are obviously going to be the largest trees, and we're gonna put these birch trees pretty crooked, and they're aiming out toward this way. Like, okay, look at the stick. They're usually aim, one's aiming like this way, the other one's aiming like that way. Okay, so maybe not so crooked, but we'll put one right about in here. I'll just go back and forth. We'll put one right here. He's coming in front of everything. He has to. He's coming right off the page there, just like that. You know, I'll make them a little thicker in the bottom. They're pretty slender trees to begin with. Okay, just like that, right off the frame there. Just getting a little more of the paint. Fucking, again, he's a little narrow down here. I gotta bulk him up a little bit right around that area, just like that. So we got one hanging around here. Okay, so that's one guy. I'm getting a little more blue, a little more of the cad, or alizarin crimson and the blue together. Dipping to some water, loosen up this paint just a little bit. No medium. The medium makes it a little too slick. So, all right. We'll put the other guy. They're usually hanging around pretty close together. So I'll put a little bit of anyway, he'll have a little bit of a curve to him. Let's just do it. Just like that. I'm bringing them straight down. I'm making white trees with dark paint. Stick with me. It'll get better after a second. I promise. Just like that. This guy. He's a little bit on the lean side, but that's okay. One had a little more nutrients than the other one. So we got two. All right, they're kind of sticking straight up, but that's all right. And while I'm doing that, okay, and I got some of this dark here, I might as well fill in this bank here. Let's work on the other side first. Getting some more titanium white. Okay, I'm putting it right on there, just like that. I'm getting some more cad red and some more blue. Okay, more cad red. I think I'm gonna need some more cad red, because that one's not as dark. And we're gonna do it again. Light side is on the right, and we're coming down. Nope, I didn't think so, but that's okay. I'm going back up, but it's all right. We're gonna straighten all that out. I didn't have enough, and plus I didn't put no medium on it. But that's what happens when you don't put the medium on. Okay, but that's all right. That's quite all right. We're gonna brighten all of that up, but I also ran out of color, which is also not a good thing. So I'm dipping back. Well, can't dip nowhere. I gotta put some more cad red on there. I do think I got enough of the blue in there, but I'll use some more if I can get a hold of it. I still think I got more than enough blue, but I'm gonna use some of this blue for the other tree. Anyway, I'm dipping into my let's dip into my red and blue first. We'll establish some really good dark. I'm going back into my other tray. All right. He's talking about holy cow. He cracks me up with that holy cow. Okay, I'm getting some strong dark. Okay, I'm gonna get some titanium white just on one side of the brush, the very tip of the brush. I just want to establish some strong dark. I'm going into the medium, loosen up this paint a little bit here so I can get this thing to flow right. Good separation here. And here we go, we're gonna do it again. Right here, right down here. Just like that. Wipe it on down here, just like so. I think you guys can see what I'm doing now. See what I'm talking about. The light side will stay light, dark side will stay dark. And if I gotta strengthen a certain side, it's easier to do so now. Just like so. I'm gonna strengthen the light side, obviously. And bring it right on up here. Bring it, travel it on up. This is just one way to do it. Bring it on up. Get some more of that white side. I'm gonna go down up here and bring it downward. And as I'm doing this, I'm moving my whole arm. Okay, and then I'll bring it on down like that. Okay. So you used to have a light side and a dark side. All right, I'm rinsing off my brush because it gets piled with paint fairly easily. I don't really have to deal with the dark side. Now, all it is me getting paint on the white side of the brush and just lighten up that white side there. Bring it on down. Strengthen up the white on one side of the tree. And basically, it's just really fading, okay? Just like that. We're gonna do the same thing on the other side here. We're gonna strengthen that one side there. Okay. We'll strengthen that side just like that. If it starts to break apart and whatnot, that's fine too. There. Okay. Just like that. I'm gonna get a little bit of the blue, a little bit of the red, mixing it together, and I'm gonna use the chiseled edge of the brush. I'm going on here on the dark side. Go straight down. If you gotta cross, go straight down, just like that. We'll establish a stronger, deeper side. This one didn't really need it as much, but I'm gonna do it anyway. Like that, get that dark side really popping back there, just like that. Okay, I'm wiping off a lot of the paint off the brush, and lightly I'll fade right in between the two lines there, just like that. Just fade them in there. Same thing here, in between the two. There you go, just like that. All right, those two guys are established, they're like right there. Let's continue with some of that dark. Actually, yeah, I'm gonna continue with the dark. I'm getting some more blue, I'm getting some more red, nice deep maroon. I'm gonna use this for a different type of tree. That's gonna be placed right here. Okay, we'll put this guy, we'll put him right here. We'll establish the roots right here, and the roots on this side, and we're just gonna block him in. We'll block him in. We have the branch come out this way. Keep blocking him in. Block him in. We'll have him turn that way. Then we'll get a branch going out this way like that. Go a little past there. And we'll get him a little something hanging out that way. Just like that. And we'll get a branch going up this way a little bit. And maybe out that way. He's got little thick branches there. Just like that. So we got one deciduous tree hanging around back there. And we'll establish some roots or whatever right up around in here. Just like that. Have some of the roots come on out. Just like that. All right. Okay, so we've got the deciduous trees in the back. We got one hanging around the midground. We got the two birches in the front there. Okay, all right. Now that we established blocking in those guys, put this one brush back down here. We'll concentrate on this fella right here. Okay. I know you guys see my monitor, but I'm gonna zoom in a little bit more. Okay, and we'll bring it right here. I get most of the trunk here. Okay, let's concentrate on that trunk. Now we already know where the light side is. All right. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take that little bit of roll of paint, okay, and we're gonna lightly, just like you would do a mountain, we'll bring it around like this. Just like that. Don't get rid of all that dark. But you see how that's established? Overlap your lines a little bit. Okay, I'm just getting a little more paint. And get it to be rounded a little bit. Okay, I'm going too far up there. Let's go right up to the top here. We'll continue right along. It goes pretty fast. You overlap a little bit and whatever touches. Do a little bit here on the bark there. You just don't want to get rid of all your underlying darks. A little touch here. Come around over here on the side and you continue it on like that. You know, as much as you want. A little bit there. Come around here like that. We'll bring a little bit of that down in here. Roll a little bit that. Oh, you guys can't see that. I'm sorry. Bad artist. There we go. We're gonna bring some of that right down in here like this. Just a little touch. Okay. See if I got any more color left here. Maybe highlight a little bit. But anyway, something like so. Alright. I'm gonna get a little bit of blue. A wee bit of blue. I usually don't do this because it kind of looks kind of comic booky when you add like a cast shadow. If you're going to add the cast shadow, keep it deep and keep it very sparse, okay, as much as you can. But I'm going to just use just a little, the faintest bit, and I'll just add some little bit of cast like that. Don't use too much of this. Very, 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 very sparse, okay. As little as you can, okay. I'll get a little tiny roll of it, and maybe I'll just tap a few. If it touches, great. If it don't touch, that's even better. I'm just doing this just to show you what you can do. Okay, right up here, just a little bit, just like that. Here and there, down below for them, just like that, and just leave it be. Got some down there too. That one gets a lot of shadow right there. All right. But that's basically it for that guy. Okay, all you would just add really is just bushes. See how he looks? That's just with a palette knife. Okay. And you can get it as detailed as you need to be. Let's go to these birch trees here. Birch trees are a little interesting because, you know, they got the black patterns here. And these are They're closer to us as in height. As in perspective, they're closest to us. All right, I'll put to you that way. Let's take a little baby brush, little tiny guy, little piece of a brush. I'm just gonna use straight maroon here. I'm gonna go phthalo blue, alizarin crimson, mix it right up. Need more crimson. Get a nice deep maroon color here. Still a little blue for me. Get a little more crimson. Kind of deepen that up a little. Okay. Little tiny brush, little baby brush. I'll put it right here. Little fella. And you're going to add interesting little patterns from the dark. Okay. I'll start down here where you guys can see it. And I'm going to just use the chiseled edge. Okay, and you can go a little flat, okay, and you circular motion, try to get it as circular as you can, a little patch of dark here and there, just like that. all up in there. Different little motions. Make sure you get a nice dark knot up in there. Go into the white side also. Okay. Little lines, little semi-lines. Get some dark ones going there. Travel it around. Interesting little patterns. I'm going further up the tree. This goes by pretty fast too. Alright. And I'm going to show you how I'm going to use a palette knife for the next stage when it comes to highlighting these guys. I'm going to stay right here at the top. Do the same thing here. Get a little patch going. Just like that. Bring it down. You see how you just have a little fun with these guys? Get a nice dark patch. A couple of them there. And you just bring it down. Curve it. Make sure you give it a little slight curve. Okay. Put one dark patch right there in the middle. And just keep bringing it down. Go horizontal on some of them if you want. Bring it on down. Bringing the camera down. But you get to see what I'm talking about here. Okay. I'm just tapping. Bringing on down. Interesting little shapes. Get a little darker down below if you would like. I'll do two varieties. I'll do the first one with a flat brush. The same little brush. Nothing but pure white. I'm going to use the side of the brush. You take the side of the... Let's go up top. Take the side of the brush. Very lightly. Right from the front of the tree. Very lightly, you just skim. Go ahead, skim. Some will break off, some won't. Just like that. Right in the front of the tree. Get some paint off the brush. Let it just collect and it'll take off what it wants, as Bob Ross would say. Getting some more titanium white. Side of the brush, lightly, don't press. Very lightly, and it'll come off. Okay, you can bring some as far down as you need to bring it. I'm going to come back up here because it needs a little more up there, like that. Especially around the edge. You got to do it as close to the edge as you can. Up around in here. Okay. Just like that. I'm wiping off the brush because you're getting some color on the brush still. So the glycerin is still pretty wet. Let's go to the second tree. You guys can see it, but what I'm going to do, I'm going to travel. And you guys are going to travel with me as I do this. I can describe it a little bit better. I'm going to get plenty of white paint here. It's on the side of the brush. Like so. Can you guys see that? Okay. We're on the side of the brush. Nothing on the other side, just this side. Very lightly. Lightly. As close as you can to the edge and just skim on across. Come on down. Just like that. I'm wiping off the brush. I'm getting some more paint. Right toward the front. As close to the front as you can, like that. Alright, travel down with me. Dipping into the white paint. Alright, and I'm going right from the front. Some of it will come off, some of it will not. Okay. I'm just wiping off the brush. I'm cleaning my little tiny brush off. You use whatever size brush that you feel comfortable with using. Okay. I just have this little micro brush. And I'm just going to, it's conducive to the size of the tree, so we're good. And I'm going to do it again. Just keep repeating. Okay. Let it break off a little bit. Make it travel a little. Okay. Bring some of that, get some of that paint up. Bring it up here. Right toward the edge, let it break apart. Okay. I'm gonna get a little dry brush and rub some of that down, tone some of that down there like that. Getting some more titanium white. We're gonna travel back up. So this is where you start fine-tuning things. Alright. Because you can go further in. And just have a little fun with this guy. Like I say, if it's too abrupt in some spots, you can always tone it down. But I kind of like that. I'm going to take a little bit of a dry brush. I'm going to scrumble in. Just tone down some of those edges there. Blend it into that blue. Just a little bit on some of them. Not on all of them. Just on some. Just like that. Now let's see. Let's check out the whole thing there. See that? You can't mistake that they're not birch trees, but they are birch trees there. All right. And we can tighten up. We can tighten up some of that too. I'm gonna clean off my brush because it's tinted with the blue, bluish gray. Wiping off my towel. Getting some fresh titanium white. And we're gonna wet as close as you can to the edge of the tree. Just a few little touches here and there, just like that. Wiping off my brush, getting some more titanium white. Bringing the camera up with me, just like so. All right, and we're gonna continue that right along, particularly on the edge. If anything, get towards the edge of that tree. It got some green in that white, that's no good. Right here on the edge, if anything. Really get that edge strong. I am running out, believe it or not, of titanium white again. But that's all right, because we're almost done here. We're on the edge there. No, it's really sad when you're this close to being finished and you still need titanium white. Almost makes it the death of you. Here we go. I wonder what my dog is doing. Why he's getting up like that? All right, we're here on the edge. Right on the top there, get some thick paint rolling off there, just like that. And bring some of that in there. Bring some of that back there. Remember what you can do. Now, you can, if it's too much, you can always scrumble some of that away. Right where I got a little bit of that green, I'm gonna cover some of that up too. Right on the edge, if anything. Get a strong edge going. Bring some of that around the other side here. Okay. Remember, you can always scrumble some of that away, mixes into the blue. Just like that, only in certain spots. Of course, I'm doing it in a spot that you guys can't see, but that's all right, we're bringing it right down. But as you can see, I brought some on the other side. There's nothing wrong with that. Scrumble some up in here. Okay. Just like that. So we got a lot of that established. Now, taking the same brush, getting some more dark established, because we're going to bring some of those darks back on that other side there. So I'm just dipping into some more CAD, or the blue, alizarin crimson and the blue. So I'm getting what's left of the red, putting it in there with the blue, which in this case appears black. All right, and you can just tighten up some of those edges there. Bring a couple of dark ones in there. See, just like that. But you see how this can work for you. Okay. Can't nobody tell you that they're not birch trees. All right. So I have no doubt they know what type of trees these are. But they're interesting patterns and shapes and such. Put a lot of knots in there, travel them around. Okay. Bring some kind of some of them horizontal, just like that. Okay, now we're gonna travel up to the top, down towards the bottom there. All right, that's not bad. Let's go here, do the final one over here. But I did this tutorial to show you what you can, just a few taps here. Okay. As you see, it's blue, and plus, once it dries, it really sets really dark. So for all intents and purposes, it does look black, even though it's not. It's nothing but a deep maroon. Actually, if you put white to it, it would look very pretty. But as of right now, with all this green and green-red mix we got happening here, some of them go horizontal like that, and bring some around there. Okay, this really makes it pop. Very craggy, like these guys have been around for a few years. All right, and we'll pop a couple right here, just like that. Have fun, please. Don't make this a chore. Have a ball with it. Have a good time. All right. please.
Okay.
Just cleaning off the little tiny baby brush. All right. I do thank you guys for checking this out. Let's take a strip liner. If you like what you see, tell your friends, hit the subscribe button. I'm just getting a little bit of, I'm taking a strip liner this time. I'm putting a lot of water in the strip liner, which is never too much water because it's only a strip liner. And I'm going into the dark mix right now. Okay, we're gonna stick up here. We're gonna stick around up here. I'm gonna go over here to the side. I'm gonna press down and we'll play with a little nice little branch coming off of this guy. Just twirling my brush around a little bit. Just like that, and we'll have a little one coming off to the side like that. And we'll have one coming here. He comes out there like this. I'm just twirling the brush around as I'm doing it because he's gonna come in front of this one tree. Okay, and I'll continue on like that. Getting some more dark, twirling it around so I can cut in front of this tree a little stronger, just like that. And I'm gonna get him thicker toward here. He's gonna have a little weight to him. Getting some more water, twirling it around in the dark mix, twirling my brush around. I just wanna strengthen this tree limb, just like that, right up in there like that, and we'll bring something coming out of there like this, and we'll have them Y across that way, and we'll have a little something coming this way, maybe coming right in front of that tree too. All it does is just establish how big this tree is and how far in front he is of everybody else. Okay, that's all that's about. Okay, I'm gonna take a little bit of white, get a touch of water, thin this white up a little bit, play some what I call little baby highlights on these guys. Just travel along a little bit. It'll mix in with the blue a little, make them a little thick so they can be seen there. This one kind of goes that way. Put it right into the branch itself. Twirl it around just like that. Okay, give it a little bit of character, a little bit of a highlight, and they know it's not snow, it's the branch itself, just like that. Okay, and I kind of like where that's headed. Bring that branch up there like that. All right, I do believe that's that. I hope that I showed you something pretty cool with this. Let's go down here, down below for 1 second. Right in this area here. I'm gonna take a little bit of this white, okay? And no palette brush or palette knife. I'll just take it right here and I'll just establish some of this right in here like that. Just a little bit of something there like that. Okay, we're gonna go over here. Yeah, you guys can see that. I'm gonna raise it up just a little bit. Just a little. You guys should be able to catch every bit of that back there. All right. I'm gonna get me just a little bit of water. A little titanium white. I'm gonna use maybe the tip of this brush. If it picks it up, great. If it don't, that's also great. All right. My camera is tracking me. That's why you see it move from left to right. And I'll just do a little bit up in here, just a little bit. If it picks it up, good. If it don't pick it up, that's also good. Remember, if it appears to be too bright, it flattens out as it dries. All right, just a little something going on in there. Okay. That's basically it. I can take, I'll do it real quick, because I'm kind of a stickler for it. So I'm gonna just take a little bit of white, flatten it out. Just a little bit. And I'm gonna go across, straight across. Oh, you can't see it. I didn't do it anyway. There. All right. I'm gonna go straight across, just like this. Go straight across. Some of it catches, some of it will not. It's okay. Go straight across a little bit, just like that. Even if it all don't make it, it's okay. Or you just take the palette knife and just touch it. See, just touch, just like that. Sometimes all it takes is a little slight touch. We'll bring some of that here. Go straight as you can, straight as you can. Some of it will catch, some of it won't. Okay. And it might be a little difficult to see it with the yellow, but that's okay. I'm gonna bring some right across like that. Right on across. A little bit of sparkle here and there. Okay. Just like so.
Once again, I'll pull this
whole
thing back.
Thank you so much for checking out this tree study here. Birch tree, and a couple of deciduous trees, one far away, one a little closer. The birch trees are the closest. Okay. I'm just putting the John Hancock here real quick. Just like so. My Facebook name should already have come across. There we go. And all that good stuff. So if you would like to try this rendition, please feel free. Okay, I'm gonna take the tape off. I don't need the tape on. I used clear tape because it gives me such a very precise edge, and I really do like, even though this is a tutorial and everything, I still like a nice edge to it. Nice crisp edge. Just like so. See that? You really can't top an edge like that, man. It's just me. You don't necessarily have to do it yourself. It's just what I prefer, what I enjoy seeing. Okay. All right. Thank you guys for checking this out. I really hope that this was a tree study that you could use and that will benefit you. Okay. I think I did a little bit of everything on this this painting. Okay. Just a quick sky, nothing fancy. You don't even notice. Remember earlier when I did the red streak, it didn't come out right. You really don't even notice it unless I pointed out to you. And it's right there, little flub right there. But other than that, very little of medium when I coated this. Okay, I put too little medium here, which is why it was a little rougher to fade, but that's okay. We still did good with it.
Okay, enough
all that. Piddling and playing around with this. It's done. So it is finished. I thank you. I really do, guys. I thank you for watching. Love to see your renditions of this. And you enjoy your day or your evening, whatever time you do watch this. And like I say, I would love to see your renditions of it. And until next time, guys, enjoy, be safe, peace, and I'll see you when I see you. Peace.